Where's the easy button? I put the notes in there. So where's the easiness of it? How do they make the music that's on the goddamn radio and that's better yet? How do they make the music that's not on the radio? That music I love. Give me the music I love. But yeah, I got some stuff trying to figure it out. I printed off the manual because I'm a nerd. I ain't a top-notch nerd. I'm a regular nerd. But this information right here, the F sharp, 3, D sharp, C sharp, G sharp, F. Apparently I'm a sharp motherfucker, or if it's just the F in the second octave or whatever. That's what I really wanted to know, like, when I'm singing, not just what these ditties can turn into, but what is it? So now I'm finna have to nerd it up and figure out, also got this stuff. I don't know how to utilize it though. I gotta be honest. So like I'm like at the very beginning, but I got some stuff. Like chords and what it all means. Where my whole I got a chord chart somewhere that I printed off because I'ma need it. You know? And then like okay, and I looked up some stuff about because it shouldn't sound like that. Like that's the ditty. That's how it came out. It's good to know what notes I'm messing with. Now I gotta try to figure out how do I build chords around that. And that's what I said, I'm gonna start back over from the beginning where I started from before. That was like the first thing I posted on YouTube. So, and I think that's probably apropos. It's probably a decent place to start out. But now I'm learning the equipment, learning the software, trying to learn the notes, familiarize myself with the keyboard, and try to maybe commit some of that to memory and just utilize these free tools that are available, free except for the ink. Good God, man, ink is a racket. It's a super racket. But yeah, now I'm finna start looking into these notes and what these notes mean outside of trying to predict what a good sound is, which I got beaucoup examples of what a good sound is. All I gotta do is listen to my favorite artists and copy and paste, basically. I don't know how they achieved it, but I don't think it's necessary that I know how they achieved it per se. Just know that when it hits your ear like it hit your ear and it hit my feelings like it hit my feelings like it's supposed to, I know that I'm there. But that's what I was really interested in. What key am I singing in? And also, what do these keys mean to those that are, I don't know, esoterically inclined, spiritually inclined? Because if it's a ditty coming to me and half the time I don't know what the ditty really is, then all of these things are important. The timing of it, the length of it, the note of it, and all of that. And plus, like, the more you expand it, the more precise you can get. I don't know. I think it's going to be a lot of fun, man, later. But you wouldn't believe how long it took me to get the notes and dots right. It didn't take me like a super long time. But I was just tripping off how I just played it. How did I hit the wrong note again? Like, goddamn, I just played it. How did I hit the wrong note again? Come on, man. Get it together. And it's like, your eyes start crossing and blurring and stuff. And it's like, Jesus. So I got a lot of respect for all of those children who their parents made them take piano lessons. And now they great virtuosos and stuff. Hats off to you, man. Because I know that you really wanted to be doing something else. But I'm glad that you did what you did. Because now we can look to your genius and be like, oh, that's how it's done. So appreciate that. And let me figure out how to do this for myself. I gotta do it. Later.